I know some of you go to church, there's just such a busy week. But you know what? When you really allow God to walk with you, you will not only feel refreshed, you will always feel strengthened. You know what saps our strength? There's just too much effort, too much thinking, too much looking at what we can do. That in the end, when we see the results of that, we either are happy, but there's no real joy, because when we try to add up to all the busyness, we find ourselves just doing it, sometimes for the love of it, sometimes for the sake of doing it. But when we look back deep inside, Lord, nasan ka ba? Were you pleased in what I did for the week? Amen? People go to church because, you know, we always welcome the first day of the week, not only with blessings, but with great expectations. Because we've been to one busy week. Diba? Amen? As you journey with God, this is not just an ever-ending up and down, trial and error, right and wrong. Diba? It's not. What's more important than a journey is the destination. Why is it important? Because the journey is not only a process or an experience. The destination is the goal to complete. It's about God taking your hand because He shows Himself to you. More than the blessing, He wants to look back at you and tell you, son, I want to perfect my character in your life. Why in the world have all these years, though we embrace the truth of God, He still is a father we do not know? Why? Because we live in a world, we were raised up in the world with so much. There are good things, but sometimes the bad things outweighs the good. Because in this world, Satan wants to see people and let people see what's dark. But you know where the light really comes in? God wanted that light to break out first in our hearts. I'm not saying don't read the news. Please read it. But when you do hear and watch it, do it with a praying heart. Don't believe everything you hear and say. You have to listen to God. Because this life is about journey. And it's not going to end with journeying. Let me tell you, God can wait. Why? Because He's outside space and time. What is man? Bible says. He will live 120 years. After that, he's gone. It's like a grass that grows up in the morning and withers before sun goes down. Life is short. Amen? I used to watch my son and his friends in high school. You know my Xbox commercial? Sabi niya, life is short, play hard. It shows a commercial about the boy being born sa hospital. Thanks! Lumipad na siya. He was like, bang! Pag gano'n, diretso sa grave. Tumatanda na siya. As he was in the air, he was from baby, puberty, teenage, 20 years old, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, tumanda. When he went to the grave, he's 70. Is that life? I mean, even in that flight, that's journey. Why are we journeying? It's not just the joy of walking with God. It's the joy walking and realizing that in every step you do, even in the darkest moments of your life, God intends that and brings that to you, even if you're right and wrong, to change your character. Because the well-meaning intention of God is to turn you Christ-like. I know for most of us, we would blame everything that happened to us growing up, even now. In fact, it was always mentioned that the only thing that stops us from fulfilling it are three main things. First is the word lie. We live with lies all our lives. There are things we believe in our family we never even asked twice. Kita'y nagtanong, ba't mo ginagawa yung ginagawa mo? Kasi ginagawa ito ng nanay, lola ko, tsaka lolo ko sa tuhod at lolo ko sa hintuturo. So I never ask. Ba't tanongin mo yung sarili mo, is that thing real? Did God really say When you look at the eyes of God, will God look the same at you? The way you look at yourself, lies. Satan is the father of lies. Too many people live in lies all their lives. Kaya nga even tayo sa church, let's be careful. There are things we believed in sincerely, and believe me guys, you're sincerely wrong. Because if you want to know if it's a lie, look at the scripture and let the word of God correct your views. The next thing that will stop you is the word hurt. Hurts are things done to you, spoken to you, and it really breaks you. Because the more you hold on to hurts, the more you become unforgiving. You know, when you hate people and when you refuse to forgive, it's like drinking poison and hoping your enemy dies. Pwede ba yan? Galit ako sa'yo! Iinimin ko itong lasa ng namatay ka! Sinong mamamatay? Siya o ikaw? Ikaw! While your enemy is partying, hinihimatay ka na dun. You live with all that bitterness and he's enjoying it, and all the more you're mad. Nagawa mo pang umiti. O nga. You're dying and he's alive. I know one day he'll repay that. But God, to God, the most important thing is ikaw. Whether you know God today that much or you don't, it affects us. It affects us. Those hurts, God allowed that to really shake whatever faith and belief you had in him. Because again, the purpose of that, with lie, he wants the truth. With hurts, he wants the forgiveness. Bakit? Because he wants you to release people. It's a saying, kung gusto mong pumangit, hindi lang yung ugali mo tsaka itsura mo, then hate your enemies. Go down to their level and you will be like them. You want a proof to that? I'm a Star Wars fan. You know what happened to Anakin Skywalker? He became Darth Vader. Right? Guwapo nun eh. Ha? Nung ano siya, guwapo niya. Mamaya, yung pala yung origin nung tun 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 tun. Tatatakot ka ba? Ha? Grabe, di ba? I mean, he used to be almost angelic. Why? Because he loves to hate. He fall into the dark side. How many people had fallen by it because we refuse to forgive? Curses. Wow. Curses are things spoken against us. Curses are things you spoke against others. Or even if you're not there, curses are passed down through family lines. Things like this will keep people away from God. There are lots of roads in the Bible. I was saying there was the first road to Emmaus. The road to Emmaus was these two guys who are disciples talking about what happened that week in Jerusalem. There was this stranger, because it's dark already, walked with them, showed them the truth. They were so enlightened, and suddenly the stranger was gone. They were talking to themselves, hey, that guy was the recent Christ. That's why our heart, when we were walking with him, it was just jumping. It was fiery. God was telling them truth. Guys, if we're in a journey, some of us may be on the same road to Emmaus. You don't know God was walking with you, telling you things. Ang tanong ko lang, what was your response? How did you even react to that? Amen? Another road was the desert road. Remember Philip? He was saying, I love it here. I mean, it's party time in Samaria. I'm welcome here. God said, that's enough. I sent reinforcement. Go somewhere else. And out of obedience, he did. He was standing on a desert road. You know what a desert road is? When you look at desert, there's nothing there but dust. Have you found yourself in a desert road? Mga Lord, anong ginagawa ko dito? What am I doing here? I'm wasting time. I know a lot of you are now in that same road. You're asking God, Lord, I'm obeying you, but nothing's happening. Let me encourage you, wait. When Philip waited, a chariot passed by. That Ethiopian eunuch changed history. To this day, that effort he did was the reason why there is a Coptic church in Ethiopia and in Egypt. They may practice a different way to worship God in an African style, but that is still the church of Christ. One effort, one heart to obey. You don't know who you touch. That's why I was saying, Korea may be in the 90s filled with millions in church. Hanggang ngayon naman eh, that the biggest churches in the world were there. The biggest one was Paul Yong Gicho. During the Korean War, he was so famished. Okay, there's a 70-year-old lady who went there from the U.S. Imagine that age. I mean, you're supposed to stay at home, di ba? In a nursing home, that lady went to Korea and helped a lot of those famished kids, teenagers. He fed this guy, nursed him, encouraged him, I don't know, helped him a lot. Maybe send him to school and what. He did things in life, he followed God, and in the end, he became Paul Yong Gicho. One of the biggest churches there in Korea. At that time, it was like 3 million people. Naisip ba ng old lady na yung tinatch niya will touch millions? I don't think so. He was just moved with compassion. We have reasons. I'm too old to do this. I'm too young to do this. I'm busy. I can't do that. Okay? I'm not ready. Maybe there's forgiveness issues in my heart. Well, I don't like that because that guy, you know, pinanggalingan niya. There's always all the reasons why. Philip never had that. He just listened to God, and I hope we had the same. Just like those two disciples walking, sharing their experience, it was God. Third guy on the road was Paul. It was after Christians to kill and imprison them, he fell on a high horse, and it became known as the road to Damascus. He got blinded. The moment he touched the ground, he knew he's blind, a voice came, the guy he was talking to, he knew. That's why he said, "Who are you, Lord?" What? Immediately he responded. I don't know, kaya kinlasify natin to. I don't know, were we the type of people to walk like Emmaus? Are we the type of people like Philip standing out of nowhere? Or they were just people full of hatred for a lot of things? I think we need to fall on our high horse so that we can really see. Bible says, scales fall off the eyes of Paul, and he became a changed man. Hey, this morning, in this journey, I want to share about the title of this message is The Road to Jericho. Wow, ang galing, ano? Jericho, why Jericho? Because this is something you know, you and I know. It's the parable of the Samaritan. Oh, Pastor Mel, ano na yan? Common na yan eh. Baby pa lang ako, no? I was suckling my thumbs and my milk, I know that. But do we really know it? It's so common. But sometimes common things are the very things God will put in your face to ask you a question. So here it is. The road to Jericho. Let me give you the intro verse. Luke 10 to 37. But let me just read Luke 10 verse 25 to 29. First, okay? Ano sabi dyan? On one occasion, an expert of the law stood up to test Jesus. Teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is written in the law? He replied, how do you read it? Galing ni Lord, ano? Ano ba nakasulat? Paano mo interpret yan? He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. You know what Jesus said? Korekek. You have answered correctly. Jesus replied, do this, and you will live. But he wanted to justify himself. So he asked Jesus, who's my neighbor? Wow, Lord, thank you so much. It's a good question, deserving an answer. We allow you to answer that in our hearts. Who is our neighbor? Let me go on. In reply, Jesus said, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road. When he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, he passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was. And when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. "Look after him," he said, "and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have." Wow. You know, during the time Jesus was going to Jerusalem, the scribes, the experts of the law, they were really up against him. They were asking him questions. In other words, they were trying to test him. Many times, people did this to Jesus to trap him. Remember the question, who do we pay taxes? Remember the question, okay, this woman married all 7 brothers when she dies. Who will be her husband in heaven? I mean, every type of things. And I was recalling a time when during the temptation of Christ, nagsalita na rin si Lord. Remember what he said to the devil in Luke 4:12? He said, "Do not put the Lord your God to test." Yet these people were testing him. You know, if there's one thing that the Lord would allow human beings to test him, it's in giving. Yun lang. The rest of that, he tells us, obey. It will be better for you to obey. Hear me and do it. Because he was saying, my commands are for your protection. Ang batas po ginawa to protect people. Okay, so this incident is almost the same as Matthew 22:35. Same people, teachers of the law, ask him, which is the greatest commandment? Same. Tinatrap talaga siya. But you know, Jesus, even if we ask the worst question, the most silly question, he would still look at your eyes and be so kind. Can you imagine Christ? He was being thrown a lot of angry questions. Perhaps unlike us, we will be so affected, magagalit na tayo, di ba? How many times tinanong ka na alam mo, tanong na walang pupuntahan? Your face will change. I just imagine the face of Christ watching. He was so interested with all these questions, and perhaps he smiled. And he asked them, okay, did you obey the law? You know what? All these things that the guy said, those are memory verses that they train Jewish kids from young age. They were preparing. That's the first verse, Deuteronomy 6:4-6. It's about love the Lord your God. Malit pa lang yung bata. So to any Jewish person, girl or boy, lalo pa naging scribe, naging teacher of the law, that's automatic. Right? It's automatic. Pag kinurot mo siya, sabi niya, love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, alam niya kaagad. So it's an automatic question. It's something that sprang out from the mind, but God is looking straight at his heart. Okay, so you know the scripture, but love your neighbor as yourself. But who is my neighbor? This morning I was saying, you know, one thing I cannot forget growing up was around 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock in the morning when I was a kid. I'm watching Big Bird, Ernie, Cookie Monster, Oscar, and, di ba? Yung mga tao dun. It's called Sesame Street. And for all the remembrance of that, kasi may mga pinapalabas pa rin Sesame Street, you know what? I can't forget about Sesame Street. It's not just the character. It's the song. The song says, it goes like this. Who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. And who are the people in your neighborhood? The people that you meet each day. Diba? Sasagot yung isa, well, a carpenter is a person in the neighborhood. Alam niya kagad yun, di ba? People that you meet when you're walking down the street. People that you meet each day. Guys, it's a challenge ba? Are the Muppets better than us? Because they know. God is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. He wants you to know who are the people in your neighborhood. People that you meet each day when you're walking down the street. Why? That's the question. You know why he said, who's my neighbor? He was trying to avoid the answers that he already know. Why? Because he will be made responsible to make sure he knew the neighbor. Now let me ask you, aren't we all lawyers? You know what lawyers does? They either acquit you or pronounce you guilty. Hindi lang naman yung judge eh. Kasi pag tinatrial ka, you're guilty! So tanong, aren't we all lawyers? Why? Because we try to justify, who's my neighbor? Amen? Ay, guwaman ko mag-study law pass. Yeah, pero lawyer tayo. We always justify. There's always a reason why I cannot do. I'm too busy. Pwede mo ko kailaan na. The last time I say hi, gisnab man ko. Diba? Sensitive tayo masyado. But you know what? You have all the reasons not to obey Christ. Because it's all valid. I'm busy, Lord. Same with this guy. Who's my neighbor? Well, that could be justified. That's why the Bible says he was justifying. Amen? Sometimes say, I have no time, believe me. When you want something, you'll find time. And most of the time, God was knocking at the door of your heart, touch that person. Because I want to touch him. I want to change that girl. Will you do that? Amen? It's not just the work of pastors and leaders, it's the work of every believer to share God's love to people. So here he is, he's being quizzed by God, and he made a good excuse. So tingnan natin, he was telling about the priest, okay? The priests are responsible for all the rituals and the worship. Priests are also the pillars of community, they are gatekeepers of salvation to the Jews. That's his job. The Levites are people that works officially for the temple and for all the needs of the temple. These two groups of men knew exactly what to do. But they ignored it. They walk away. The priest may have a reason like all of us. I don't want to be ceremonially unclean because when he watched the guy, he was beaten black and blue, left for dead. So duguan yun. And for a priest, you don't touch that because that makes you unclean. It will take 7 days to clean you up before God, ceremonially. I won't do that. So he was thinking about purity laws. Same way with the Levite, ganun din naman. Halos second to the priest yun, mga assistant yun eh. So they won't do that. They was just watching. But God was saying, hey, above all your ceremonial laws, your purity laws, is the importance of every human life. Let me remind you guys, law was made for man and not man for laws. God's not breaking rules here, but he was saying, kahit pa yun ang batas, may above dyan human life. They never even checked on him. You know the thing about this? It was already in the afternoon, so if you're in a bandit clock, that's 9 to 5, pauwi ka na. Tapos na yung priestly duty niya sa Jerusalem. He was going back to Jericho. Oh! Okay, same with the Levite. Tapos na yung trabaho sa temple. Hindi. But you know what? Somebody came. It's the Samaritan. The race they hate so much. Because it's so intermixed. They don't know if these people are still Jews in their bloodline. Do they still worship God? Remember the woman at the well? People, the Jews avoid Samaria. Samaria is smack in the middle of the Holy Land that time. It used to be the kingdom of Israel because when Solomon was gone, the kingdom was divided and split into two. Israel and Judah, right? Israel was first to go. 10 lost tribes of Israel was carted off around 727 to 722 BC by the Assyrians. Sila Sargon, si Salmaneser, inubos nila lahat yan. They're gone. So the conquerors, what they did, talaga para to make sure walang loyalty doon sa nationalism, they put people from other lands in there, left only a few Jews, and the Jews were taken far, far, far away. So nag-intermix na. Those people married their women, women married. So we don't know who's... That's why Jesus never followed the usual route, because Jews will travel here at Perea by the Jordan or by the Mediterranean, which is really longer than taking a shortcut into Samaria. They won't do that. It's unclean to them. In fact, there was a rabbi long ago who said this. You know what that rabbi said? Sabi niya, taking a bread from a Samaritan is like eating the flesh of pigs. Ganun talaga sila. I mean, hate talaga nila yan. When a Samaritan would give you bread, it's not bread to them. Parang pork yun. Sobrang salaula yun sa kanila. So never even touch what the Samaritan touched. They're unclean people. And here is a Samaritan looking at a Jew na hindi tinulungan ng kapwa niya Jew. You know, the laws of the Bible says, let's look at Leviticus. Sabi doon, okay, for priests, kaya hindi niya ginawa yan. Speak to the priests, the sons of Aaron, say to them, priest must not make himself ceremonially unclean for any of his people who die, except close relatives such as mother, father, son, daughter, brother, or an unmarried sister who is dependent on him since she has no husband. For her, he may make himself unclean. He must not make himself unclean for people related to him by marriage, so defile himself. Wow, purity laws. Totoo yan, dapat lang. But what God says, what above all these purity rites, is when a man needs help and life is threatened, forget that, save the guy. Saving him should be checking on him because he's a Jew. The rules of life outweighs the rules of purity. Isa pa, when there's a dead Israelite, they had to bury that quickly. Kahit maging unclean ka pa, because that's the rule of the land. That guy died alone, walang relative. Ano? Sino magtuturuan ba kayo ng Levite? You bury him. If he's really dead, but nobody's checking. Samaritan went in, kinuha siya, binandage siya, took him on a horse, put him in an inn, make sure okay siya doon, stayed a night pa. Imagine mo yun? And told the innkeeper, here are 2 denarii, sobra na bayad yun. Ha? Hindi pa siya nakaka one day, di ba sa hotel, 12 to 12? Sobra. And if this guy stays here in the car, pagbalik ko, I'll repay you. Wow. Wowie. And he was again in your face telling that scribe, the teacher of the law, ano? Sino neighbor mo? I want to leave us with this. Who is really neighbor to us? Amen? Pamilya mo mismo, neighbor yan eh. Charity begins at home. Hello? There might be a lot of reasons for us not to reach out, but God is saying us the rule of love precedes. Wala kang karapatang mag-say no, because love is a command. It's never an option. It's never a choice. Forgiveness is a command. It's never an option. It's never a choice. God wanted His people to love. If you say you love God, just like this guy, kahit nakapikit, to love the Lord your God and to love the neighbor, he failed the 50% of the test. The love thy neighbor. To love God is vertical. Okay, walang problema dyan eh. But to love horizontally with your fellow man, that's always gonna be a big question. Because just like this guy, he had prejudice. Sabi nga nila, the opposite of love is not hate. You mean, the opposite of love is not hate. It's indifference. Yung hate surface lang eh. Yung indifference, sabi ko nga, it's a smoking gun. Amoy mo may pulbure. Wala ka narinig. Bumagsak na lang yung tao. Somebody fell dead because that gun had a silencer. Patay. How many people will have silencers shooting people? You cannot see it in front. It's a silent hate. Same here. You cannot love if you have that. Amen? Hate is just the outward appearance of indifference. You have reasons to be indifferent, to be prejudiced, to be discriminating. Bakit? Matthew 5:17, sabi dito, do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish but to fulfill them. It was Christ telling matatalinong tao sa Israel, I'm not abolishing anything. You are not doing what I told you to do. I'm doing it for you. Romans, it says 13:8, let no debt remain outstanding. Dapat na walang tao may utang sa atin except the continuing debt to love one another, for he who loves his fellow man has fulfilled the law. Wow. Wala naman akong utang eh. Totoo. Wala kang credit card. Lahat bayad. Sobra ka pang magbayad. Pero may utang ka pa rin. Ang tanong, have you ever loved people? There was a movie I was watching before and inulit ko yun eh. It's called Bucket List. Two guys dying of cancer. One diagnosed to have 5% chance to live. He lived longer after that. One guy so rich, the other guy is poor enough, but they have different stories. The rich guy married 4 women, but he said, I never married them, never loved them anyway, but I am married to my work. Now you're super billionaire, you own the hospital kung nasan tayong dalawa, and the other guy was a mechanic. Forget about all his dreams because maaga siya nag-asawa. He had 3 kids, 1 wife, never been unfaithful to the wife for the last he can remember, never been. Kahit nung tinem siya, hindi talaga siya bumigay eh. Had 3 kids, one was a lawyer, one was an engineer, the other one was an accomplished violin player, babae. Love his family all his life. So sabi nila, let's make a bucket list. Sulat sila, okay, it's witness something majestic. Sabi sa, you know, laugh until I cry. Sabi naman nila, okay, kiss the most beautiful girl in the world. Later on, he realized that was not another lady. That was her grandchild by the only daughter he had. Because in the end, he got reconciled. So I said, okay, mag-parachute tayo, magpatato tayo, let's ride a sports car like it's the end of the world. Let's go to places, Africa, Riviera ng France, top of the world. They went to Egypt. And on that time, they were on top of the pyramid. They were asking because Morgan Freeman, there was a man of faith. May faith siya kay God. He asked Nicholson, so we have questions because we're in Egypt. In the Egypt of old, the time of Pharaoh, there always is a question when a man dies. He faces an individual, perhaps to them it's God, and he'll ask you two questions. If you pass, you go into the eternity, Egyptian eternity. What are the two questions? O sige nga, sabi niyan, dito na tayo. First, have you found joy in your life? Hindi niya masagot yun. Kasi enjoy niya pera, miserable na siya eh. Next. Have you in any way brought joy to the life of other people? Ang sagot niya doon, no. Hindi niya masabi. Because he made people miserable. Let me ask you. There was this pastor doing research about people who came back after flatline. Yung pinabalik ni God. Some people will ask, siguro ang sinasabi ni God the question, what have you done on planet Earth? That's not the question. Every one of these guys, one was so mad because he was so accomplished, God never asked about his accomplishment. All of them were saying, when we went back, there's one question in that eternity, and we saw a man that looks like Jesus. The question is, have you loved others when you were on Earth? And they were crying because they know they failed. Who is my neighbor? Amen? That may be a long-lost friend, that may be a kapitbahay, an office mate, a classmate. Okay? The one nakaka-basketball mo. That may be a basurero na taga-pick-up lang doon. Let's do it. So I believe the very question to ask is, Lord, alam ko accomplished tong line na to eh. Because I know, I really talk to you, I really am, you know, in any way, I may not be perfect yet, but I know this is good. But let me fix this. So you notice what that is? If that's up and this is equal, that represents cross. So what have we done ba in our life? Have we really come to a point of acknowledging, Lord, ano yung kulang talaga sa buhay namin? But sometimes we work, even in church and even outside, there was nobody even to tap your shoulders. and to tell you how good God is and how good God's plan is in your life. If we learn that, start at home, then going outward, believe me, I don't care how many more people will be in the church. They'll be taken care of not by the one pastor, two pastor, or three pastor. They'll be taken care of by every one of us. Amen?